Right. First, let me introduce myself to you. My name is Dr. Cuthbert Aloysius here. I'm with the Romaine Society.
Yes.
Here in Sri Lanka.
Sorry, for which? Where are you calling from?
I'm calling from Sri Lanka.
Yeah, no, sorry. You said the Romaine Society.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah. In your projects, do you all have anything in the pipeline to preserve the bird life?
Where? At the resort? Hambantota or in Colombo?
The Colombo area is my question, you see.
Oh, okay. We're working with environmental consultants limited, so we have an agreement with them.
Yes.
As both of the projects are still in the construction stages,
yes,
we're doing scoping visits and we're putting together environmental plans, which will look at habitat protection and conservation. And then we're putting together plans to be able to then say which species need to be conserved, what we need to do to propagate their habitats, or what needs to be done. So that's happening for the Hambantota project.
Sorry, what is that?
So as far as Colombo goes, we're still at the initial stages of piling. So we haven't started anything as such yet.
Yes. Now, I am a ornithologist by profession, and I am specializing in birds. Now, this area is very much a habitat for pelicans, as you are probably aware. Yes. Now, have you seen this? You have seen this phenomenon.
I'm sitting at the site office now.
There you go. Now, as you can see, there will be an influx of pelicans, especially during the May period. Do you know why?
Okay.
Do you know why?
During May.
Yes.
Because of all the...
Because of the Vesak season. Now...
Yeah, all the food that's left out.
That is correct. The pelicans are usually migratory birds, you see.
Yeah.
And usually by June, they usually go to the down south areas.
Okay.
Right? That entire area will be covered in pelicans if they are not given an alternative habitat.
Okay, as you know, the only area that we cohabitat, that we're based at, is actually the site, but there's no...
Correct. Once you have built all the buildings, the pelicans take it as a signal to inhabit.
Okay.
It is like squatter's rights, you see. This is the mentality of pelicans, you see. And
As they find an area too.
And then they send out that mating call. They have
kiss.
Yeah.
That is the mating call of the pelican that they will sound in order for the females to arrive. The only solution that y'all have is to at least grow 300 trees over 5 feet of height. And you can either have it around the perimeter of the entire construction, that is the only option that you have at the moment.
We don't, as you know, I mean, we're still very much in the primitive stages of construction here.
Yes, yes.
But then at least I can pass this on to the construction team over here, the projects team, and then we can look at that and incorporate it.
Have you heard of the blue tit?
The bird, yes.
Yes, you have heard. Yeah. Have you seen the blue tit?
No.
Now, the impact is, it is like a knock-on effect to the blue tit. And the blue tit is endangered.
Okay.
Right? Now, I will send you all of this.
Just also the type of trees, all that kind of thing that needs to be planted.
Trees, very good.
I can pass that on.
Very good. Very good.
Okay.
I have one more thing. I must thank you for your time. I think you were very gracious. Do you also know a Miss...
Yes.
Yes.
Do you know that she just nominated you for a prank call?
Oh my god. Oh my goodness. I knew there was something wrong with that. That's so embarrassing.
If you think someone deserves a good pranking, send in your nominations to gem@kissfm.lk or mark@kissfm.lk.